Good afternoon, children. Welcome to today's session of maths. Let us start today's class. Before going to today's class, let us revise what we have learned in our previous class. We learned about prime numbers and composite numbers. Also, we started with the test for divisibility of numbers. What did we learn? We learned divisibility by 2, by 5 and 10. Do you remember? Can you tell what is the rule for 2? Rule for 2 is any number which has 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 in its ones place, that number is divisible by 2. Yes? Can you tell the rule for 5? Rule for 5 is any number with 0 or 5 in its ones place is divisible by 5. The rule for 10 tells that any number with 0 in its ones place is divisible by 10. Now in today's class, we'll learn about the divisibility of different numbers. Yes? Let us start with 3. Which are the numbers which is divisible by 3? Can you tell? Yes, of course, it is 3, 6, 9, as it goes, 18 or 27. Yes? You may be knowing only till here. Beyond that, now suppose you have some numbers like 3,469 or 8,844 or 7,000 or 99,456. How will you know whether these numbers are divisible by 3? Let us see what the rule tells. For example, I'll take an example of 816, you think. Yes, this is a number 816. By looking into the number, can you tell whether it is divisible by 3? No. So what is the rule? The rule tells that you will add all the digits in this number, that is 8 plus 1 plus 6. When you add all these numbers, what do you get? 8 plus 1 is 9, 9 plus 6 is 15. That is, you will add all the digits in this number and the answer what you get, that is the sum what you get should be a multiple of 3. Is 15 multiple of 3? Yes, of course. 15 is a multiple of 3. So, 816 is divisible by 3. Did you get it? It may be any number. It may be a 3-digit number or a bigger number. The rule is same. Let us see again. I'll show you another example. Suppose you think 7,469. Now, let us add this number, all the digits. 7 plus 4 plus 6 plus 9. Yes? 7 plus 4 is 11. 11 plus 6 is 11 plus 6 is 17. 17 plus 9 is 26. Yes? 26, is it a multiple of 3? Is it multiple of 3? No, it is not a multiple of 3. So, this number is not divisible by 3. Did you get it? This number is not divisible by 3. That is the rule for divisibility by 3. Hope is it clear? Let us move on to the next one. That is divisibility by 4. Yes? Divisibility by 4. For example, 756 8,018, 9,346, 8,086, 378, 1,072, 1,032. Now, how to find out whether these numbers are divisible by 4? The rule tells that you will see the numbers in the 1's place and 10's place. This is 1's place and this is 10's place, is it? So, you will look at the number, that is the number which is in the 10's place and 1's place, whether it is a multiple of 4. Whether it is a multiple of 4. Can you tell the multiples of 4? It is 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 20, 32. It goes like that. Okay? If you don't know whether it is divisible or whether it is a multiple of 4, you just divide it by 4. Divide it by 4. 56 when you divide by 4. 4 ones are 4, 1 is remaining. 6, 4 fours are 16. Yes, is it divisible by 4? Yes, is it 56 a multiple of 4? Yes. So this number 756 is a divisible by 4. Same way, let us see the next example. That is, what is the number in the 1's place and 10's place? That is 80 here. 80, is it a multiple of 4? If you don't know, just divide it. 80 by 4. 4 2's are 8. Yes, 0, we bring it down. We cannot further divide, so add a 0 there. So, is it divisible by 4? Yes. So, this number is also divisible by 4. Now, look at this example. The last two numbers are 42. Yes, 42 is a multiple of 4 or not? No, it is not a multiple of 4. So, this number 9,342 is not divisible by 4. Okay, same way, look here. Here we have 56 again. We have already found out 56 is a multiple of 4. So, 6,156 is divisible by 4. Here you see 78. Yes, 78 you divide by 4. When you divide 78 by 4, 4 ones are 4. What is remaining? 3, 8. 4 nines are 36. What is remaining now? 2 is remainder. So, 78 is not divisible by 4. So, this full number is not divisible by 4. Now, look here. In this example, we have got 1032. 32, is it a multiple of 4? Yes, of course, it is a multiple of 4. So, 1032 is divisible by 4. Hope I am clear. Let us move on to the next one. Now, let us see. Divisibility for 6. If you want to know whether any number is divisible by 6, what is the rule? We'll see. For example, yes, look at this number 3469. If you want to know whether it is divisible by 6, this number should be divisible by 2 and 3. Both. It should be divisible by 2 also and 3 also. Is it divisible by 2? First of all, no, it is not divisible by 2 because the last number is not an even number. So, this number is not divisible by 6 also. No need to see whether it is divisible by 3 because already we know it is not divisible by 2. Let us see another example. Thousand 1503. Here you see whether it is divisible by 2 and 3. It is not divisible by 2, but it is divisible by 3. Is it or not? When you add the numbers, 1 plus 5 plus 3, it is 9. It is divisible by 3, but not divisible by, it is divisible by 3, but not by 2. So, it is not divisible by 6 also. Yes, let us see another example. That is 1936. So, look at the number in the ones place. It is 6. So, it is divisible by 2. Is it or not? It is divisible by 2. Yes. Let us see whether it is divisible by 3. 1 plus 9 plus 3 plus 6. When you add these numbers, what do you get? 1 plus 9, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. 13 plus 6, 19. 19, is it multiple of 3? No, it is not a multiple of 3. So, it is not divisible by 3. So, it is not divisible by 6 also. We will see another example. Now, here let us see whether it is divisible by 2. Yes, it is divisible by 2. By 2 it is divisible. Let us see for 3. 8 plus 5 plus 3 plus 2. How much is it? 8 plus 5, 13. 13 plus 3, 16. Plus 2, 18. Is it divisible by 3? Yes, because this is a multiple of 3, it is divisible by 3. Hence, both the conditions are satisfied. It is divisible by 2 as well as by 3. So, it is divisible by 6 also. Yes. So, 8532 is divisible by 6. It is divisible by 2, 3. So, it is divisible by 6 also. Yes. Let us go for the next number. 8. Can you tell what is the rule for 8? What was the rule for 4? For 4, we saw the number in the tens place and ones place. Now look at this example here. Look at this example. 7,51,324. Now, if you have this number, how will you know whether it is divisible by 8? What was the rule for 4? You will see the numbers in the tens place and ones place and see whether it is a multiple of 4. Here, for 8, we see the last 3 numbers, that is the number which is in hundreds place, tens place and ones place. What is the number? 324. Divide only these 3 numbers by 8. 8 fours are 32. What is remaining here? 0. Now take the number down, 4. As we cannot divide further, we stop it here. Yes, we add a 0 here. Yes. Is it divisible by 8? No, it is not divisible by 8. So, this number 7,51,324 is not divisible by 8. Let us see another example. Four, two, nine. 7, 1, 0. So the number is 4,29,710. Yes. Now the last three numbers, that is 710. Let us divide and see whether it is divisible by 8. Yes. How will you divide? 8 are 64. What is remaining here? 7 is remaining. Yes, when you borrow 1 from here, 7 is remaining. So we get 70 here. Again, 8 are 64. We get back 6 again here. It is not divisible by 8. So the number 4,29,710 is not divisible by 8. Let us see another example. Let us see another example. 14,560. Yes, here the last three numbers, that is the number in hundreds place, tens place and ones place, will take, that is 560 divided by 8. Yes, 8 sevens are 56. Remainder is 0. We take another number from there, it is 0. So here it is divisible by 8. Is it or not? So the number 14,560 is also divisible by 8. Is it clear, children? Let us see another example. That is, can you read the number? The number is 17,90,184. So here the last three numbers, that is 184, should be divided by 8. Yes, instead of dividing the full number, we take only the last three numbers and divide it. So 8 2s are 16. What is remaining here? 2. Let 4 come down. 8 3s are 24. So, is it divisible by 8? Yes. Since 184 is divisible by 8, the full number, that is 17,90,184, is also divisible by 8. Okay. Now, let us see how to see the divisibility by 9. Yes? It is the same as divisibility by 3. How we did that? The same way it is. Example, 7, 4, 3, 2, 2. Suppose this is the number 74,322. Let us see whether it is divisible by 9. What was the rule for 3? We added all the digits. Here also we add all the digits. That is 7 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 2. What do we get? 11. 11 plus 3, 14. 14 plus 2, 16. 16 plus 2, 18. 18 is a multiple of 9. Is it or not? If you add all the digits in the number, the sum what you get should be a multiple of 9. Then this number, that is 74,322, is also divisible by 9. Is it okay, children? Let us see one more example. Three 30715. Yes, as I told you, add all the digits. 3 plus 0 plus 7 plus 1 plus 5. Yes, 3 plus 7, 10. 10 plus 1, 11. 11 plus 5, 16. 16, is it a multiple of 9? No. So, this number 30715 is also not divisible by 9. Okay? So, what all we learned till now? Yes? We have learned about divisibility of 3 in the beginning. Then we learned about 4. Then 6. Then 8 and 9. Yes? Do you remember? For 3, we will add all the digits. Yes? When we add all the digits, it should be a... The sum should be multiple of 3. Here for 4, we'll see the last two numbers. That should be a multiple of 4. Is it or not? Multiple of 4. It should be. The 6, if you want to know, it should be divisible by 2 and 3. Yes? For 8, the last 3 numbers you will see, that number should be a multiple of 8. That means it should be divisible by 8. For 9, what was the rule? Again, add all the digits and the sum what you get should be a multiple of 9. Hope I am clear, children. Okay, thank you.